Hello, I am Dr. B.V. Rao of Usha Clinic and founder of the website skewmedicaldoubts.blogspot.in and drvaghavamedicaldoubts.in. In these videos, I am providing the basic knowledge about the commonly occurring diseases for the knowledge of the general people and for basic knowledge for medicals. Today, I am going to discuss about the diabetic retinopathy. As the name suggests, the diabetic retinopathy is a condition of the eye where, secondary to the diabetes, the retinal blood vessels may swell and leak fluid. In others, the abnormal new blood vessels may grow onto the retina and cause vision changes, and if not treated, they may cause blindness. It usually affects both eyes. Types of diabetic retinopathy. Mild non-proliferative retinopathy. This is the first stage where small areas of balloon-like swelling in the tiny blood vessels of retina are formed, termed microaneurysms. Moderate non-proliferative retinopathy. If untreated, some vessels of retina are blocked and cause the progress of the disease. Severe non-proliferative retinopathy. Many blood vessels are blocked and retina sends signals to the brain to grow new blood vessels for nourishment. Proliferative retinopathy. New blood vessels are grown along the retina and in the vitreous chamber. As these are fragile, if leak, may cause haziness and vision loss or blindness. Symptoms. In the beginning, there are no symptoms. If there is a leakage of blood, macular edema is caused, there may be blurred vision. If vessels on the retina bleeds, there could be block of vision. In proliferative retinopathy, the patient may see few specks of blood or spots floating in the vision. There could be blurred vision due to the bleeding. May clear up spontaneously but may recur. If not attended, may cause severe vision loss or blindness. Diagnosis. Visual acuity test. It measures how well one can see at various distances. Dilated eye examination drops are placed in eye for dilatation of the pupil to enable the ophthalmologist to examine the signs of the disease with the help of the retinoscope to view. Leakage of blood vessels. Macular edema or retinal swelling. Pale fatty deposits on the retina. Signs of leaking blood vessels. Damaged nerve tissue due to vessel damage. Any changes in the blood vessels due to diabetic changes. Tonometry. The pressure in the eye is measured with a tonometer after installing the anesthetic eye drops. Fluorescent angiogram. A special dye in the eye is injected into the blood and pictures of the blood vessel of retina are taken. Treatment. Treatment of the retinopathy in first three stages. Diabetes is controlled, and if hypertension and cholesterol are project controlled properly. Proliferative retinopathy is treated with a scatter laser surgery. The surgeon places 1000 to 2000 laser burns in the area of the retina away from the macula, which causes the abnormal vessels to shrink. Repeated treatment is necessary to complete the treatment. It is effective before the vessels are fragile or bleed less. After treatment, there could be loss of some sight vision and color vision. Vitrectomy. It is done in case of severe bleeding. It is a surgery where the blood is removed from the center of the eye. Treatment of macular edema. Focal laser treatment is done by placing several hundred small laser burns in the area of the retinal leakage surrounding the macula if one have macular edema. That's all about the diabetic retinopathy. In the next video, I will discuss about some other disease. Thank you.